Why delay your breakthrough? Sometimes our miracles, what we have always craved for, is hanging around our heads. Our deliverance is already around, yet we can't see it. We can't see them because of our unwillingness to hear God. To achieve success in life, to achieve success in school, you must be willing to follow the instructions of your instructor. Success doesn't come by just doing. Many are stuck in the cave of hard work without following instructions. Proverbs 4:20 NLT version says, "My child, pay attention to what I say. Listen carefully to my words. If you listen to what I have to say, what God has laid in my heart as a burden to tell you, your life will change. Your success will spring forth like the wings of an eagle." I didn't know myself that life or success in life is predictable until I learned what I'm about to share with you. God already prepared everything for us to succeed. Yet you will always have people that will be laid back, poor, or draw back to lack, to complain, or stagnations, or to struggles. Because it takes those that follow through the process that guarantees success that will triumph over the shortcomings, the obstacles, the challenges, by paying attention to the instructions. Joshua 1 verse 8 says, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate on it day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." It says all that is written therein, none to be left behind, but to do all. God is daily giving us instructions through this book of the law. In doing this, He narrows down the instructions based on our peculiarity through the nudgings of the Holy Spirit in our spirit. God daily impresses His word in our hearts to enable us to do something that will make our breakthrough materialize, which is what we've been praying for, which is what we've been believing Him for, which is what we are expecting to materialize. Some of us don't hear or trust the voice of the Holy Spirit because we have not developed our relationship with Him. Yet He is waiting till we get it. Why keep yourself at the current level when all you need is to follow simple instructions? In John chapter 5 verse 8, Jesus said to the man with the infirmity, "Rise, take up thy bed and walk." It took him 38 years to hear these instructions until Jesus came on the scene. What instruction are you ignoring? In Acts chapter 3 verse 6, Peter said to the man at the beautiful gate, the man that was lame from his mother's womb, the instructions were, "Rise up and walk." In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. The man obeyed, rose up. Peter, stretching forth his hand, helped him up because he took that step to rise up, to walk. So instruction was, "Rise up and walk." And the man walked and leaped and celebrated and followed them into the temple. Is it in Matthew 2 verse 13, God through His angel gave instruction to Joseph, the father of Jesus, "Take the child and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I will bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him." Imagine if Joseph had argued with God at that particular point based on the promises God made concerning the life of Jesus. But Jesus was a baby. He was a deliverer, but He needed to be delivered even as a child. So sometimes God gives us instruction to push us into safety. God gives us instruction to prevent us from what lies ahead, from what we cannot see that only Him can see, because He declares the end from the beginning. That's why He said that it is important we obey and listen to the instruction God has given to us. There's instruction God is giving to you right now that you might be ignoring because it sounds stupid or foolish. And if you don't obey it, your breakthrough cannot come. Jesus would have been destroyed. As a child, Jesus would have been killed if Joseph did not obey the instruction of God through the angel. You cannot joke with any form of instruction you are receiving. And that is why you need to understand that your breakthrough lies in obeying this simple instruction. What instruction are you ignoring? What are the instructions you are ignoring? The call to give your life to Christ or to trust God in your situation that it will come true for you, or to hand over the fight for him, or to trust him for your relationship. The breakthrough could be in letting go. In John 6, 8 to 9, the little lad with the bread and fish was ready to let go. He gave out his fish, he gave out the bread, and his willingness led to abundance. What are you holding on to? What are you not willing to let go? Until you are able to let go, the fight, the struggle, the pain, the shame, or the little success you think you have, that's when breakthrough will come. That is when abundance will come. Why delay your breakthrough? Why delay your breakthrough? God wants to use what you have in your hand to promote you. God wants to use what you have in your hand to lift you up. God wants to use what you have in your hand to open doors for yourself and for many. Until you let go, you might not be able to see. You might not be able to hear. And if you cannot hear, you might not be able to obey the instructions that will open the door to your breakthrough. Why don't you just trust God? Why don't you just hand over your life to the Creator and Maker of all things? Why don't you just follow through the nudgings that you've been having in your spirit? Why don't you just obey the instructions? Yet they might sound stupid. They might sound very foolish. But the Holy Spirit, his foolishness, are wiser than the best of man. Trust him with your life today. Trust him with your life today. Trust him with your life today. God bless you. Real good.